will be a sign for you on the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you. No destructive plague will touch you when I strike Egypt.
Get involved in this bizarre practice. In the past, the fact that we were Hebrews was sufficient, enough to keep the plagues distant. For instance, when darkness covered the land of the Egyptians 3 days, to we Hebrew slaves light was given. And God did this without the death of a lamb. Is this his command or the request of a man calling himself a prophet? Yeah, I know he's a good leader, but he's taking it too far. This is bizarre, as I remarked from the start. Before Pharaoh lets us go, you more likely see the Red Sea part. I'm not putting blood on my door. What do I look like, a fanatic? The rest of the people can have at it. My neighbor Eliezer shared a lamb with me. I took half, tonight I'll cook that and share with family. Because if God performs a miracle tonight, who's to say that Pharaoh's magicians won't duplicate it? It's complicated. So as night falls, I pray to God that my firstborn will see another dawn.
I admit it's a strange sight, but tonight it's on. I'm applying the blood to the door like Moses warned. He said the house that lacks the blood, there will be a curse on. From that house, God will require the life of the firstborn, which refers to me, cause I'm the first of three. I prepare the sacrifice with urgency. A year old lamb without defect for my family slain. Mix it with hyssop and apply the blood to my door frame. And though I don't understand, I trust that somehow redemption is found in the blood of the lamb. So with my staff in hand, I make haste. 11 cakes are baked, and the herbs we eat leave a bitter taste. Like the slavery we've endured for 400 years. But little brother, stand strong and mother, dry your tears. Cause soon we'll all be in the promised land. And this is all possible because of the blood of the lamb.
In the darkness of the night, when the Lord came down, he brought death to the house where the blood wasn't found. But the man who believed, he was blessed indeed. Cause unto him was granted life to the firstborn seed. Since then, Pharaoh's power has come to an end. Yet mankind is still a slave to sin. But there's an exodus to the promised land. Again, God has provided a Passover lamb. I just can't understand why Yeshua would say, no man took his life, but he gave it away. What kind of Messiah is that? To receive blows from his foes and let Rome control without striking him back? Where's the victory at for Israel? If he's the Messiah promised, I'll be honest, I can't tell. The man failed at fulfilling my expectations of who the Messiah was to be to the chosen nation. I've heard it said that it was prophesied the Messiah would be despised and rejected, suffer and die for the sins of men. And get this, so say his proponents. Okay. His blood is an essential component for atonement. The concept of blood atonement sounds barbaric, to be honest, and doesn't line up with my concept of who God is. The Ten Commandments, I can't even keep the first one, but others are worse than me. Overall, I'm a good person. So in the afterlife, I'll just trust in my good deeds. Although my heart is filled with lust and greed, the Messiah need not bleed to pay for my sins. I'll work my way into heaven. At least I pray I get in.
I admit it was strange to me when I first heard it, cause I was told the Messiah would come to make the earth perfect. Thus the verdict was that Yeshua was not the one, and the Messiah was yet to come. Until the day that curiosity led me to honestly study the prophecies, I saw aspects of Messiah that weren't taught to me. It was foretold, not only would he come to provide peace, first the Messiah would act as a high priest, providing atonement once and for all, as Daniel foresaw. While the temple stood, he would be cut off. Isaiah gave the imagery of the lamb led to the slaughter, wounded for our sins, bruised for our iniquities.
It is he,
I explained. Yeshua fits the description. God wouldn't leave Israel without a sacrificial system. He provided himself the lamb, Yeshua the Son of Man. Then he said to David's Lord, come sit at my right hand. By faith I believe it, thus life I receive it, like the firstborn back in Egypt. Heed the words of John, who when pointing to Yeshua declared, behold the Lamb of God.
At the end of the age, when the Lord comes down, he'll bring death to the man on whom the blood isn't found. But the man who believes will be blessed indeed, cause unto him is granted life for eternity. Pharaoh's power has come to an end, yet mankind is still a slave to sin. But there's an exodus to the promised land, so where do you stand with the Passover lamb?